Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I am Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 23rd of April. PM Modi chairs high-level meetings as India posts world record daily COVID cases. UNEMA won't pause efforts to support Afghan peace process, says envoy Deborah Lyons. And people in southern India celebrate annual temple festival amid pandemic. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi chaired high-level meetings about prevailing coronavirus situation in the country and oxygen supply shortage on Friday. Modi spoke with chief ministers of 10 states with the most number of COVID-19 cases and assured them of best efforts in sufficient oxygen supply. India reported the world's highest daily tally of coronavirus infections for a second day on Friday, surpassing 330,000 new cases as it struggles with a health system overwhelmed by patients and plagued by accidents.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday held a meeting with chief ministers of 10 states with the most number of COVID-19 cases. The meeting via video conferencing comes amid a huge daily surge in coronavirus cases, which has now clocked over 300,000 in the country. Prime Minister Modi assured the chief ministers of best efforts in sufficient oxygen supply. Daily infections hit 332,730 on Friday, up from 314,835 the previous day, when India set a new record, surpassing one set by United States in January. States like Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Kerala are badly affected during the second wave. Several hospitals in capital New Delhi, Mumbai are facing an acute shortage of oxygen, which is essential in the treatment of COVID-19. The government is working hard for better coordination between states, hospitals and suppliers of oxygen and vaccines to meet the demand. The Prime Minister also held a meeting with the country's leading oxygen suppliers on Friday.
और हम यहाँ पे बलरामपुर लोग बंधु के अलावा हम किसी को नहीं दे रहे हैं।
जो पहले प्राइवेट लोग अपना छोटा सिलेंडर या खुद लेने आते थे तो अब क्या उनको मना कर दिया गया?
उनको मना कर दिया गया शासन की तरफ से कि आप सिर्फ बलरामपुर और लोग बंधु को दीजिए बस।
मेडिकल ऑक्सीजन एंड बेड्स हैव बिकम स्कार्स विद मेजर हॉस्पिटल्स पुटिंग अप नोटिसेस सेइंग दे हैव नो रूम फॉर एनी मोर पेशेंट्स एंड पुलिस बीइंग डिप्लॉयड टू सिक्योर ऑक्सीजन सप्लाईज. A new, more infectious variant of the virus, in particular a double mutant variant that originated in India, may have helped accelerate the surge, experts said. India, a major producer of vaccines, has begun a vaccination campaign, but only a tiny fraction of the population has had a shot.
Deborah Lyons, UN envoy and head of UNEMA, has said she has wrapped up consultations aimed at strengthening peace talks with Afghan parties and international partners in Doha on Thursday. In a series of tweets, she wrote that there will be no pause in work to support Afghan peace negotiations.
The UN envoy for Afghanistan, Deborah Lyons, on Thursday concluded several days of consultations in Doha with Afghan parties and international partners about the best way forward to strengthen and add impetus to intra-Afghan peace negotiations. In a series of tweets, UNEMA, United Nations Assistance Mission in Afghanistan head Lyons said, there will be no pause in work to support Afghan peace negotiations. UN is continuing its engagement with both Islamic Republic of Afghanistan and Taliban representatives to maintain a focus on peace efforts and the path to a just and durable peace settlement. This comes after Turkey, the UN and Qatar in a joint statement announced the postponement of the scheduled conference due to the non-participation of the Taliban in the summit. However, a trilateral meeting between foreign ministers of Turkey, Afghanistan and Pakistan will take place on Friday. Meanwhile, the head of U.S. forces in the Middle East, Marine General Kenneth McKenzie, during a Senate Armed Services Committee hearing on Thursday, said that he was concerned about the ability of the Afghan security forces to hold territory after the withdrawal of all foreign troops from the country in the coming months. President Joe Biden announced last week the United States will withdraw its remaining 2,500 troops from Afghanistan by September 11, the 20th anniversary of the Al-Qaeda attacks that triggered America's longest war. Biden's decision to withdraw all U.S. troops has raised concerns that the country could erupt in full-scale civil war, providing Al-Qaeda space in which to rebuild and plan new attacks on U.S. and other targets.
In news from Pakistan. Pakistan on Friday reported 144 new coronavirus deaths, raising the nationwide death tally to 16,842 on Friday, while total infections surged to 784,108. Prime Minister Imran Khan has urged the public to follow COVID-appropriate behavior to avoid a complete lockdown.
Pakistan on Friday reported 144 new coronavirus deaths, raising the nationwide death tally to 16,842 on Friday. Meanwhile, the country recorded 5,870 new infections, taking the confirmed cases to 784,108. Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan, however, on Friday decided against implementing a full lockdown across the country and appealed the people to strictly follow the standard operating procedures to contain the surging COVID-19 infections. He regretted that the people are currently not observing caution and warned if citizens did not apply with the health guidelines, authorities will have to impose lockdowns in the cities.
Ab bilkul SOPs pe pichle bari ke muqable mein shayad hi koi ab amal kar raha hai, lihaza ab hame sakhti karenge. और मैं ये उम्मीद रखता हूं कि अगर आप SOPs पे चलेंगे तो हमें फिर वो जो सबसे खौफनाक चीज है शहरों का लॉकडाउन वो हमें नहीं करना पड़ेगा.
The government was earlier expected to impose lockdowns from Friday. However, it issued guidelines, some of which include closure of schools in high-risk zones until Eid. Only essential businesses can operate after 6 p.m. and offices capacity will be allowed to be 50%. Pakistan's already fragile economy had only just been moving towards stability when the health crisis struck last year. Experts fear that the pandemic's economic fallout will considerably derail the country's recovery process.
Moving on. A report released this week by a U.S. Rights Commission has expressed concerns over religious freedom conditions in Pakistan, which continue to worsen as the government systematically enforced blasphemy laws and failed to protect minorities. It reveals there was a sharp rise in targeted killings, forced conversions, and hate speech targeting religious minorities.
Religious freedom conditions in Pakistan continue to worsen as the government systematically enforced blasphemy and anti-Ahmadiyya laws, according to a recent report released by the United States Commission on International Religious Freedom, or USCIRF. The report states the government failed to protect religious minorities from abuses by non-state actors, and there was a sharp rise in targeted killings, blasphemy cases, forced conversions, and hate speech targeting religious minorities. It also highlights that the issue of abduction, forced conversion to Islam, and forced marriages remained an imminent threat for religious minority women and children, particularly from the Hindu and Christian faiths. In the year 2020, there were reportedly 30 Christians, including 7 on death row, jailed in Pakistan on charges of blasphemy, said the report. It recommends enacting reforms to make blasphemy a bailable offense, ensure proper investigation, and allow authorities to dismiss unfounded accusations and enforce existing penal code articles, criminalizing perjury and false accusations.
In news from Nepal. The four leaders of Nepal's CPN-UML party, who were suspended by the party chair for 6 months, have moved to the Supreme Court, challenging Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli's action against them. The CPN-UML leaders, who faced the risk of being removed from the House of Representatives for their alleged anti-party activities, have filed a writ petition at Nepal's apex court, seeking annulment of punitive actions taken against them.
The four leaders of Nepal's CPN-UML party, who were suspended by the party chair for 6 months, have moved to the Supreme Court, challenging Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli's action against them. The CPN-UML leaders Madhav Kumar Nepal, Bhim Bahadur Rawal, Ghanshyam Bhusal and Surendra Prasad Pandey, who faced the risk of being removed from the House of Representatives for their alleged anti-party activities, have filed a writ petition at Nepal's apex court seeking annulment of punitive actions taken against them by Oli. The first hearing of the case has been scheduled for April 25. The four UML leaders have stated in their petition that Oli is preparing to expel 27 UML lawmakers from the House of Representatives, falsely accusing them of trying to split the party. Meanwhile, Oli has sought explanation from 27 lawmakers of the rival faction within his party, asking them why they should not be removed from the parliament.
As part of an extensive plantation drive by the Department of Floriculture in India's Jammu and Kashmir, chinar trees are being planted with an aim to preserve their heritage value. According to the Floriculture Department, the number of chinar trees in the Kashmir Valley has been reducing over the past few years.
Under an extensive plantation drive by the Department of Floriculture in India's Jammu and Kashmir, chinar trees are being planted with an aim to preserve their heritage value. According to the Floriculture Department, the number of chinar trees in the Kashmir Valley has been reducing over the past few years. As per surveys, there used to be around 50,000 chinar trees in the valley, but now, unfortunately, it has reduced to about 35,000.
बदकिस्मती से देखा गया है कि कुछ सालों में वो घट रही है क्योंकि जो सर्वेज हम वक्तन फवक्तन यहां पर कर रहे हैं या हाईएस्ट नंबर यहां पर चिनारों का तेदाद रहा करता था वो कोई 50,000 के आसपास था बट नाउ अनफॉर्चूनेटली ये तेदाद घटकर कोई 35,000 के आसपास है
कश्मीर में ये तो चार चांद लगाता है हमारे हुस्न में चाहे वो अक्टूबर हो नवंबर हो या आज का दिन हो या सारे सीजन का माहौल हो तो चिनार लगाना बहुत अच्छा है क्योंकि ये सकाफत का हिस्सा है कश्मीर में तो मेरे ख्याल से हर एक कौम के फर्द कश्मीरी को चिनार लगाना जरूरी है
अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट्स ब्यूटी द शेड ऑफ द ट्रीज इज आल्सो हाईली कंड्यूसिव फॉर हेल्थ एंड गिव्स अ कूल ब्रीज
The annual temple festival of Thrissur Puram was celebrated on Friday in India's southern Kerala state, adhering to strict COVID-19 protocols. In the view of surging infections in the state, the celebrations were massively scaled down and were held in a low-key manner with only limited number of people and inevitable rituals.
The famous temple festival of Thrissur Puram was celebrated on Friday in India's southern Kerala state, adhering to strict COVID-19 protocols. In view of the surging infections in the state, only a limited number of people associated with the Puram rituals and locals were allowed to attend the celebrations, which usually witness a sea of thousands of people thronging at the ancient Vadakkunathan temple in Thrissur. The main attractions of the over 200-year-old festival are grand elephant parades and performances of traditional musical ensembles. Thrissur Puram is celebrated on the day when the moon rises with the Puram star in the Malayalam calendar month of Medam, generally between April and May. King Sakthan Thampuran of the 18th century Kochi Kingdom is believed to have commenced this festival that transcends religion, caste and community linkages. Last year also, the Puram festival was held in a low-key manner amid the COVID-19 lockdown curbs, with just a handful of people and inevitable rituals.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. PM Modi chairs high-level meetings as India posts world record daily COVID cases. UNEMA won't pause efforts to support Afghan peace process, says envoy Deborah Lyons. And people in southern India celebrate annual temple festival amid pandemic. Now, our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.